In Trinidad, last year, we performed this song, the song of Rapiatra. You know, after the cards come to the site. And I did something that we had never done before. Trinidad is known for steel bands. Anybody know what steel band is? They take oil drums and then create instruments. It's a very unique sound. So it's like a national instrument. So I thought, why not use it and get them? So I got a little school school children. Now they teach them how to play in Trinidad in school. So I got one group and I taught them this melody. And it was a surprise at Rapiatra when there's a bad recording of it. I mean a poor recording of it on YouTube. But someone taped it with their cell phone and put it on. It was wonderful because the pan, the steel man, playing it, it was just perfect to sing this song. So, here, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is a request to everyone to chant the names of Hari, Mandir, and Agnideva with a blissful. Man means mind. This is mind. So this is how we should chant. You know, it's a wonderful thing. Wonderful feeling to chant. So especially in Kirtan, we can chant the name of the Hari in happiness. He said, Janami Janami Sukhin, birth after birth. Says, Manav Janma Pedai. Again, we have obtained a rare human body. It is a rare body, out of 8,400,000 species of life. Dulava Manav Janma Satsanga. It is rarely achieved. So, you use it wisely. So he says, now that you've got this human form, hey, this human form, Lord, or human form, right? Chant the names of pain, whether you're in happiness or distress. Sukheta, Purvukheta, Bhoya, Bhoya. In the third verse, what does it say? Ah, yes. Whether you are in prosperity, of his fortune. She chants the name of Radha. And whether you have a one and a half, whether you're living at home, a family, or as a sannyasi in the forest, because previously sannyasis used to live in the forest. While remaining in the material world, you can chant the holy names for Krishna's purposes. In pleasure of Krishna, we chant. Asat Sangha, there is Satsanga. Satsanga means the company of devotees. Real meaning of satsanga is sat means truth. Sat also means eternal. So in the company of devotees, we hear about the truth, speak the truth. When we get together with one another, the conversation should be Krishna conscious. We shouldn't misuse the company of devotees for what is called gossip. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he told Raghunath Das Goswami, Ramya Kata, I'm not sure. You see, Raghunath Das Goswami came from a well-to-do family. This was mentioned in Chaitanya Charitamrita. He came from a very well-to-do family, almost like king. But he was attracted to Lord Chaitanya. He wanted to go and join Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And although his father and mother were very pious, they were also devotees. They were very pious. They didn't want him to go and join Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We saw this many times. Srila Prabhupada, he told us that before coming to the West, you know, Srila Prabhupada was a businessman before he was a chemical, pharmaceutical business. So he met many business people. And after many years, by Krishna's grace, he retired from the business. Actually, Krishna made his business failure. That was a special mercy. Krishna says so in Bhagavatam, that when I especially favor someone, my first installment of mercy is to take away everything from him. So he has no other course but to surrender. The Prophet said when he worked hard to build up his business and then it crashed, he asked one of his board members, meditating on this verse, he asked the board member, he said, do you think this verse applies to me? He said, definitely. So he said, before coming to the West, he would approach people that he knew, business people, that he had established relationships with. He said, I approached several of them and asked them, I said, my dear sir, you have four sons. Give me one of them, and I will train him in the first class in Vaishnava. I will train him to my children. Said nobody wanted to do that. They all wanted their sons to be doctor, lawyer, engineer, this and that, you know, standard fare. Prabhu said even his mother wanted him to be back. And the last time he came to LA, we went to a recording studio that was owned by the host of Golden Avatar Studio. And he did the recording in Simon Bhajan. But he wanted to sing it in a dhotar. And at that time, hardly anybody, any of the Menanga players in this country played in dhotar. There was only 1, 2, 3, that was all we knew. So when no one could do it, you know, they tried. Three or four people tried and they couldn't do it. He kind of gave up and said, all right, it's not happening. So they told him, well, why don't you come back tomorrow as the Prabhupada and you could act in Madanga. So you could double track. You could play, sing, and then run. So he did that the next day. And when he came the next day, to everyone's surprise, he started singing on Tinta. And if he had done that the day before, everybody could have done it. So, and then he requested, after singing it, he requested Amar Ganga. There's some, the recording, and he was filled with some of his pictures of it. And when he had the Mandir, he began to